Well, it's National Mutt Day, and here locally, our city is almost 100% to becoming a no-kill city. News Channel 9's Tatiana Favela is live in the newsroom with more.
The El Paso Animal Services Center is asking for your help in becoming a no-kill city, meaning you can be a part of that and not just by adopting.
My future goal is to be a veterinarian and just help as many animals as I can.
Samantha Aguilar is one El Paso teen with big goals set ahead, and she's already starting to prove that.
This gives me a perspective of a young age, just to see just like how much is going on around me and just how much help they don't have, and I can provide that for them. And as they grow older, I can provide more.
The summertime is when Animal Services has the most animals looking to get adopted or fostered, the center receiving 80 to 100 pets per day. Meanwhile, they're continuing to push El Paso to be a no-kill city.
We're in the 80s, and that last percentage for El Paso to become no-kill is the hardest.
And that's where you come in.
It's just a great time because this is going to show what El Paso can do. The El Paso community has to come together for us to get that no-kill.
While focusing on saving these animals, Animal Services also wants pet owners to make sure their pets are chipped or at least have a tag.
If you do have animals in your home, let's try to keep them there. Our goal is to keep the animal in your home and not here in the shelter.
In the meantime, Aguilar plans on being a part of completing that mission for El Paso to become 100% no-kill.
They need someone the same as people do.